Hey everybody, welcome back to Distill 405. It's Justin here. Big shout out to our followers. We love you guys. Thank you so much for following us, especially when we're just starting out here with all these reviews. So really do appreciate you. So if you are watching, which I know you are because I know you're our diehard followers, I am going to be reviewing something very special. This, let me just say something. I have about five beers that I just love. This is one of them. For one, it's a Belgian ale. And you know how I love Belgian ales. I'm gonna be working through a few Belgians here. My last review was on the St. Bernardus App 12. I think I have it. Yeah, got it right here. So yeah, so go check out this review. Fantastic beer. There's a reason why they call it the world's best beer. But aside from that, this is probably the second best beer in all the world. Because I had to travel about halfway around the world to actually get it for the first time. So it is the Cuvée du Château, I sure hope I did not butcher that, from Castile. It's from Castle Brewery. Delicious, delicious Belgian quad. So let me give it a pour here and I'll tell you the story on how I acquired this one. It's a fun story. It definitely added a dripping on there. Oh goodness, that color, you can't beat it. Okay, so not too much of a head here. Typically, I probably just poured it a little bit wrong, but you're supposed to get about a one finger head to it. Off white, and wow, I kind of poured that a little too full, but I'm gonna drink it all anyway. So on the nose, ooh, it's just, man, you definitely get that quad smell to it, which is just a dark, rich flavor. Again, these beers are treats. They're not chuggers. These are things that you need to enjoy. Belgian beers are like, they're not the Coors Light, Miller Light, or Budweiser beers, okay? Where you don't bring this to a pool party. You definitely sit down, enjoy this with hopefully a very nice meal to accompany it. But yeah, I wanted to show you that there. So bottled at 11%. Again, quads are typically always dark. Well, typically always. They are always dark. Bottled anywhere between, I've read somewhere with 10 to 14 or 9 to 14% ABV. Typically, you're going to see a 10 to 14. Very rich flavor, dark flavor, smooth flavor, like dark fruits are very common with quads. So comparing it to the St. Bernardus in a sense, let's give it a try. If you are drinking it with me, cheers. If you're not, join me later. Go out and buy it and join me later. I'm not getting paid, by the way. It's just, I want you to enjoy good beer, so go out and buy it. Let's give it a shot. Cheers. Oh, so good, so good. So right out of the bat, you get a very smooth mouthfeel, dark in flavor. I'm gonna say a tart red fruit note, as well as a, 1 second. Yeah, tart red fruits. Almost like a, I would even put the tartness on like a cherry flavor. You kind of get that in the back end. Slight dark chocolate. Again, like I said, smooth mouthfeel and just a very pleasant finish with no lingering flavors, which is good. I like that. I like that with beers. You finish your sip and then you go back for more. Nothing that kind of adds on top of each other throughout the beer. So fantastic. But anyway, I said I'd give you that story. So you know me, I try to give you background. I like history. I like stories. So, hopefully you like them too. But so Daniel, it's typically how they start out right now. I know Daniel does introduce me to a lot of different things because he tries so much so fast. Like the guy is just like, he'll buy like everything on a shelf and then like try it within a within a month and be like, which is great, right? Because it lets me know what to buy and what to stay away from. But he told me about this beer well over a year ago. And he said, dude, like one of the best beers I've ever had. Like you need to try and get it. Well, so I live in Dallas and I've searched like every specs, every total wine that is in a reasonable driving range for me. I could not find it except for the cherry flavor that Castile makes. Now, it might be good. I'll review it. Hey, since I brought it up, I'll review it here soon. It probably isn't bad, but I don't know. Cherry beer, I don't know. It doesn't do anything for me. So I'm like, okay, great. You have the cherry. Do you have this? They're like, no, we don't. Oh, jeez. So when I was finishing up my degree, if you watch my other videos, you know I've just recently graduated last year. And in the process of this, I got to travel abroad to England. And I got to present some stuff that I'd worked on in my degree at Oxford and Cambridge. And while I was there, I went to some liquor stores and lo and behold, I found this in like a London marketplace. And I was like, oh my gosh. You know, so I spent about, like £8 over there, which means you just shouldn't do the conversion rate on it. It's by far probably the most expensive beer I've ever bought, a single bottle beer that I've ever bought. Not even like a nice, you know, tall bottle, just, one glass. So I bought it. When I flew back, me and my wife, I was so excited to try this, and it did not disappoint. So that's the story behind that beer. And then you're wondering, well, how did I get this? About a month ago, I found it at Total Wine. I'm like, no. After I had to fly overseas to buy it, now as soon as I get back, you know. But hey, it adds to the story. And now I can buy it for a lot cheaper. I'm glad. So anyway, I'm gonna go in one more time. If you're drinking with me, by all means, let's go again here and get another round. Man, just so good. Yes, everything and more that you would want in a quad. I will say it's a little bit different. So let me just compare it to the St. Bernard's real quick. The St. Bernard's was the App 12, by the way. Probably one of the most balanced, flavorful beers I've ever had, especially quads, Belgian quads. This is absolutely delicious. No reservations on it at all. But I would say where it ranks with that is, which one would I have immediately? I'm gonna be drinking both for forever. But the next one I would probably wanna get is the St. Bernard's. And just because it's so well-rounded and flavorful, I just want it again. This I will drink again, but like I said, it's different. You definitely get a very dark, cherried, red fruit flavor, and it's a little tart on the palate. Not as carbonated as the St. Bernard as well. But again, both very delicious beers. So I don't think I showed you guys the color, but again, it's a quad, so you know it's gonna be basically dark, but just a very dark, dark brown in the coloring on that. And again, fantastic beer. So anyway, guys, I'm gonna wrap this up, but thank you very much for watching this review. Always appreciate your comments. Let me know what you're thinking. Let me know what your thoughts are. Again, I wanna hear your thoughts on what you're drinking. So if you have any suggestions for reviews, again, let me know about it. If I can find it, I'll pick it up and I'll do a review and give a shout out to you as well for the suggestions. So follow us on YouTube for our updates. We'll be posting some stuff here pretty soon. As always, we post stuff throughout the week. Again, follow us on Instagram and Facebook for weekly updates on what we're doing, what we're looking at. It's a great way to connect with us too. Again, aside from just posting these videos and talking about things that we're enjoying, we want to hear from you guys about what you're enjoying as well. And me, Daniel, Aaron, we'll be responding to you here real quick. So. Anyway, you guys have a great day. Again, As always, thanks for watching and following us. Cheers. Have a great day.